Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we start a new chapter of learning the codeless programming logic for the reason that we start learning objects. And objects is perhaps one of the most exciting parts of codeless. And it's particularly useful one when you start working with UI builder applications or backendless database or backendless system in general, because for the most part, everything will be presented as objects. And understanding how objects work and what they are and how to manipulate objects will be key to creating fantastic programs and, you know, adding any kind of complexity that you want. So let's talk about objects and what they are. First of all, an object is a data structure. And the structure of that data structure is actually quite simple. It consists of key-value pairs. So for instance, if we take an object that represents a person, some of the properties of that person can be name, can be age, can be phone number, can be address where that person lives. And these individual properties, they essentially become keys. So a property is essentially just one of the qualities that an entity that the object represents has. So these key value pairs essentially can describe anything that an object represents. So let's stick to the same person example. So the properties or the keys that we have identified are name, age, phone number, and let's say address. The values that correspond to these keys would be individual values of any of the supported data types. And at this point, we have covered all data types in Codeless. And those are strings, numbers, booleans, arrays, and objects. So here, in this case, we could have name as with the value of, let's say, Bob. An age could be a number, for instance, 35. Address, the value of address can actually be another object that represents address. And in that other object, the properties and keys can be street name, city, state, zip code, or postal index, country, with the corresponding values. And that chaining effect of going from one object through its property to another object and to another object can continue to describe some very complex data structures. And in fact, in the actual applications that you will be building, those data structures become very real and you'll be dealing with it pretty much anytime you work with Codeless or any kind of programming system, because the concept of objects is universal in most of the object-oriented programming languages and systems. And Codeless is definitely one of them. So here, as you can see, the concept is very simple. A combination of key-value pairs, and those are referred to as properties, where the value can be any of the supported values. Seems very simple. And it really is until it becomes complex. So let's take a look at how you can create objects and how you can work with objects in Codeless. So here we are, we will continue with that person example, and let's create our very first object that would exist in Codeless and just see what kind of things we can do with it. All the object-related blocks, most of them, are going to be in the object category. So here we have 8 of them. And the first one is going to be the block that can create an object. So let's take this out. And let's also create a variable. We will call this variable person. So we will set the person variable. The value of that is going to be our object connected here. And whenever you use this block, by default, it will create this property that's called prop name. And this is just a placeholder. And it is expected that you will modify it to be whatever makes sense in your application. In our little example, it makes sense that this property will be called just name. And then we will have another property. And as you can see, I'm just dragging it out here. You have seen this approach already in the if else statements or in the blocks where we need to compose text. Same concept applies here. And pretty much all the blocks that support this kind of extensibility, it is done through this gear icon. So we will have name, we will have age, we will have, for instance, how about a Boolean value that will represent whether this person is retired or not. So we can say is retired. That's it. And to add values, these are going to be the same blocks that you are familiar with to create the actual values. So for name, the value will be a string. And let's say that the name is going to be Bob. And then for age, it will be a number. So we will drag out the number. And let's say that that person is 35. And then for is retired, it is going to be a Boolean. So the Booleans live in the logic category. So we drag this one out and we say false. So that person is not retired. So now the person variable, this little variable, contains this object. And all the operations that object support can now be performed on that variable, because inside of it, it is going to be an object. So first of all, type checking, which is one of the earlier lessons that we went through. If we go into logic, there is this block that determines whether a specific value is of certain type. So in here, if we bring the print and connect this one to print, and let's use our person variable to check if it is of type object. Let's run it. And we will be getting true. So number one, we know that objects, they are of type object. That's kind of a self-explanatory. Now, if we were to print out the actual object, and I know we've been using print a lot, and this will not be an exception. So if we print out the actual object, let's see how it is going to be represented in console, which will give you more or less kind of visual representation in terms of how it is actually structured. So let's run this. And here we got our object, and this is the actual internal representation of that object. So as you can see, all the properties are printed like this, and then there is a corresponding value. The color of that value indicates the actual data type. So strings are going to be in quotes, booleans just like this, and the numbers. And then you could have other data types. So the same object may have other properties that would be of type array. And then another property that would be of type object. For instance, we talked about address, and we will get to this. Inside of arrays, by the way, we talked so far about the arrays that contain strings and numbers. But an array could actually be an array of objects. Nothing stops you from doing that. We'll be getting to that at some point. So now we know what an object is and what it looks like, and we can print it out. Let's just look into some of the most basic operations that you can perform on an object. And then those operations really just give you a full scale of all the different things that you can do to modify what that object looks like. For instance, the very next block in the list of these blocks is set property in. So let's see what that block does. The very first connector will expect the actual object that needs to be modified, but it needs to be an object. So we will be using the object that is sitting inside of the person variable. The property connector expects the actual property, meaning the actual key value that you will be updating. The properties that we have in that object are name, age, and is retired. So if you reference any one of these, you can modify the value, means in this case, let's say if we modify age, we can modify the value that corresponds to that property. So let's say we will be modifying property age. And let's say that this person has gotten a little bit older. So we'll say that now he is 37. Okay, so if we were to print out that person again, so this one is before the change, this one is after the change, let's see what's going to happen to our Bob. So this Bob is younger, this Bob is older. As you can see, age is now 37. Whenever we modify that property, the actual change occurs within the object itself. So no new copies of it going to be created. We have that object, we go inside and basically say, okay, age property, you're going to be a different value. And you assign that value. Simple as that. Using this mechanism, you can modify any of the properties. In fact, using exactly the same mechanism, set property in, you can actually assign new properties on the fly after those objects are created. So for instance, let's say we learn that Bob purchased a phone and now he has a phone number. So how about this? We can set a new property in the person object and we will call it phone number. And that phone number will be a string. And let's say it's going to be this number. And at this point, the person object, our Bob, now has a new property that will be called phone number. So if I print out, again, person variable, you'll see that now this is what it looks like. You see it got this new property, phone number, with that value. The value that you assign, again, can be any supported data type. String, number, Boolean, array, another object can actually be undefined. Let's see, what else do we have in here? Get property. So this block right here is going to be symmetrical to get property, to set property. So in here, if we want to retrieve a value from the object, this is the block that we can use. So for instance, if we want to see what the value of a specific property is, then we put the property name. So for instance, we put the property, how about phone number? Phone number. And then this block needs to have the actual object from where we will be retrieving the value. Okay. And let's run it. And as you can see, it just printed out this value. So here we obtained phone number from that specific object. There are some rules on the property names. So they need to be one whole word. You cannot use spaces. You cannot use dot. You cannot use dash, I believe. If you stick to the rule that is just one word with Latin characters, cannot start with a number, and just keep it very descriptive, that's kind of a good rule to follow. So no special punctuation signs, essentially just letters only. You can use numbers, but cannot start with a number, okay? That is going to be it for now. There will be a series of lectures dedicated to objects, but for now, I will keep it short because I just wanted to focus on the concept of objects, how to create it, how to set properties, how to retrieve properties. And as we continue, these cases will become more complicated, but they're going to be equally important. Thank you for watching this video, guys. And as always, happy Codeless coding.